things in the heat of argument, and Holden probably already regrets what he said to Rod.
Holden is more hostile than I've ever seen him before. Seth had to break up two fights with him in camp.
He's going through a lot these days. He's going through a lot of changes.
I know that, and I'm taking that into account, but Rod is my father. I wish that he would take that into account.
Okay, okay. I gotta call him. I'll see if I can find out what's bugging him, all right? Hey? Here we go, sir.
Yeah. Lily, if I don't see you, have a nice break.
Thank you.
Lily? I hope you'll come and stay at the farm tonight.
Oh, I don't know about that. I'm not sure I want to get into another argument with Holden.
I think Holden's already on his way to Chicago to see the Langs. Holden likes playing the hero, and it looked to me like Angel was ready to give it to him, considering what she told me earlier.
Feel about me, but Lily's been upset all day, and I know it's because of you. When you're hurt by someone you love, it makes your entire life miserable, and I don't like seeing her like that the night before her birthday.
What do you know about love? You're nothing but an animal.
Really? I suggest you learn how to be civil if you want a relationship with her, because I'm going to be a permanent part of her life. Got it?
If you ever threaten, if you ever come between Lily and me, I swear to God, I will kill you. I should have killed you that night you came out to the farm with Maggie when I had that gun pointed at you.
You'd better do something about this streak of violence in you, Holden, because I hate it. What are you gonna do? Shoot everyone who comes anywhere near me? Or anyone I might be friendly with? Like Caleb or Spence? Holden? You got a phone call.
You and Holden got pretty loud upstairs.
Well, that's because he's being so pig-headed, and I'm not gonna take it anymore. One minute, he's blaming Caleb. One minute, he's blaming Josh for whatever's wrong between he and Lily. And now he's gonna leave for Chicago.
Would you do this thing for me?
Oh, all right.
And miss Lily's party?
Yes, and it's just going to make it worse between them.
Hello.
Holden, it's Angel. Did I call it a bad time?
No, not at all. Angel, it's so good to hear your voice.
I could call back if you'd prefer.
No, I'm serious. Hearing your voice has helped more than you'll ever know.
The Emmy Award winning As the World Turns. This portion brought to you today by Comet. For your modern surfaces, today's Comet. As safe as a liquid, as tough as Comet. And by Love's Deluxe. With the Night Guard system and truly tear-proof taping.
No, I'm really glad that you called.
Well, I couldn't go to sleep without telling you how much better I feel about myself and everything since this morning.
I'm glad to hear that.
It was very difficult to face Caleb and hear him say he never really loved me. But I don't know. I feel like it's all behind me now.
That's some accomplishment for one day.
I know. It's all because of you. I think you came into my life just to help me face the truth about Caleb. Anyway, I called because I was wondering if you know yet when you'll be coming back here to work with my father.
I have some things to take care of with Craig. We have to work out some scheduling problems. Maybe tomorrow or the next day, I don't know. But I'll let your father know as soon as it's settled.
Will you let me know too?
Absolutely. I'd be more than happy to.
Thank you. I feel so much better knowing that I'll be seeing you again soon.
I'll call you tomorrow, one way or the other. But you sleep tight, okay?
I will. Good night, Holden.
Good night, Angel.
Well, it's nice to see that someone can pick your spirits up.
I was just happy to hear Angel sounding so optimistic.
Who?
Angel Lang. She's the daughter of the man that Caleb worked for.
Yes, she and her father were here this morning.
Oh, yeah, you said something about that in the hospital. I never really understood why they were here.
Well, Angel came by to see Caleb.
Caleb? Oh, she's the girl that Caleb had the big thing for, that Ellie was telling us about. What was she just telling you?
Just talking, Maggie. She doesn't have very many close friends.
Isn't that interesting? Caleb's old girlfriend's now calling you.
I got things to do.
Well, my dear, I see the old gang is here. There's Pam and Bo. I'm gonna go talk. You just keep up the good work.
Would you do me a favor?
Sure. What, girl?
Would you call Holden and make sure he's okay?
When you say favor, you mean big, big favor.
Yeah, well, it would mean a lot to me.
What do you care what Holden thinks after what he did to you earlier?
I always care about him, Caleb. Please, would you do that for me?
Okay, I'll do it for you, but I wouldn't do it for anybody else. All right.
Hey, I was thinking of swimming in Mother's Pond later. So maybe you join me.
Look, Greg's gonna talk to Holden to see that we should go ahead and have that wonderful surprise party for Lily right down here tomorrow, huh?
You think that's such a good idea?
Oh, yes, for sure, that'd be a good idea.
Well, she's been in a kind of a rotten mood lately. I don't know, maybe she doesn't want to have a party.
Well, all the more reason she should have a party given to her by her friends.
Well, maybe she's supposed to be alone with Holden tomorrow night.
Lily, Ivan wants to talk to you. She says Holden's there, but he spent most of his time in his room.
Thank you. I owe you one, Kelly.
You got it.
I'm just worried about Holden. He was in a real ugly mood earlier. He almost got into another fight with Rod. No, I haven't decided yet. I'd like to come out to the farm, but I don't want to get into another argument with Holden.
Actually,
yeah, I'll let you know what I decide. Bye.
Well, at least Holden's not off somewhere taking out his anger on someone else.
Didn't Iva tell you?
What?
She said that Holden had cheered up considerably.
What? Why?
Well, evidently Angel called and he was all smiles.
So many things. They're all about you and they're all terrific.
Rod?
Oh, yeah?
I can't breathe.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just want to hold on to this moment forever. If I had my way, I'd never let you go.
I want you to know that my being here is no accident. I wanted to be here with you because you have been the one true comfort through the toughest time of my life.
I think maybe Betsy might have understood if it had only happened once, man. Maybe the first time at the farm, it was just circumstances that got out of our control, but the second time, in my apartment, the night of the ball, we knew what we were doing, Maggie.
You lost her. That's it.
Hi, I hope you don't mind my dropping by. If someone is here, I can go. We can talk.
No, I'm alone, Betsy. I'm very much quite alone. Do you think I have women parade in and out of here because I was honest with you?
No, I didn't mean to imply that. You just had a funny look on your face and you didn't ask me in. That's why, you know.
I'm just a little surprised that you're here. Please, come in. You know, you're always welcome.
I thought we should have a talk.
Sit down.
Aren't you going to sit down?
No, I think I'll stand. I wanted to talk to you, too. In fact, I was out at the cabin earlier, but you had company.
Yeah, Seth dropped by.
Did you tell him about Maggie and me?
No, of course not. No, all he knows is that we're having some problems.
I don't want to cause any more trouble for Maggie. I promised her right up front that I would never tell you that she was the other woman I was involved with. I didn't figure it would seem so obvious to you.
Well, I admire you for trying to keep her name out of it.
She tells me Tonio would go berserk if he ever found out.
Well, he won't find out from me. I promise you that. Look, I think you should know that Emily told me that she thought she saw you going into Meg's apartment tonight.
She showed up right after I got there. I went to Maggie's. Maggie was a little worried about me.
Well, that's why I'm here. You see, because whatever the reason, and I believe what you just told me, I don't feel that it is any longer any of my business.
Come in.
Hi. I just wanted to make sure that you have everything you need.
Oh, yeah, everything's fine. I don't even think I could lose anything in here.
Oh, well, listen, you could take my room. This would be fine for me.
No, that's okay. That's not what I meant. I mean, it's fine for me, too. See, I've, you know, lived in my dad's house and my mom's house, so I can live out of a suitcase.
Yes, well, I've moved many times myself, okay. So... you know, until I came here, there was really never any place that was home. You should think of it this way. You have two wonderful parents who just happens to love you and want to be with you.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I do.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to sit down and play some Scrabble? I got a Scrabble board here. You want to play?
Yes, sure.
All right.
Okay, good. You're not too tired?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Where'd Tom go, you know?
My father was very disturbed by the phone call from Margot, and it made him restless.
I don't like that. I mean, she calls him even after she's already said that it's over.
Yes, it is so confusing, and it makes my father so upset. Andy, I really wish there was an easy way to help people stop loving someone and wanting to be with them.
Oh, yeah. But there isn't, Leanne. I know that for a fact.
Lisa, did you forget your keys again?
It's Sonia of Lisa. I have no keys.
Okay. Hi.
Hi.
Come on in.
Thanks.
I thought you would have been asleep a long time ago.
Yeah, me too, considering I was up all night last night.
Well, there isn't more trouble with Dylan, is there?
No. Casey and Lila stopped by to make sure that Leanne was okay, and we did a great job of avoiding our one topic of discussion, or should I say our one topic of non-discussion, when guess who called?
Margot?
Yep.
Why? Why would she do that?
Well, she said she was concerned about Leanne. I guess John filled her in on that.
Oh, she's not being fair to you.
Tell me. In her defense, maybe she was concerned. I don't know.
But to call you? What did you do?
Well, my reaction was pretty much the same as yours. Then she did something very out of character for her lately. She hung up on me.
You've got to find her, Don.
I know. I just can't sit on my feelings anymore.
Well, there's no reason why you should. Find Margot and get her to answer your questions.
First thing tomorrow morning, I call Washington.
I'm owed some favors up there, so I'm going to call him in now. I know this hush-hush vacation of John's I'm sure he's spending with Margot, the first part of which he's going to go see Dusty in Rome, so maybe she's in that general area. I don't know.
You are very wound up.
Yeah, hence the late-night strollings.
I have the cure for you. Two stingers coming up. They are lethal, but they'll do the trick.
Well, I'll try anything, John, as long as one's for you.
Oh, this is a cure that no one should take alone.
Shannon, no.
What?
I have a favor. When I find Margot and ask her about all this and talk to her, you think you'd keep an eye on Leanne and maybe take her somewhere?
Oh, while you're doing that? Sure. I'd be delighted to. In fact, I will even stay at the cottage so she won't feel uprooted. Just tell me, you have to find Margot. You have to get her to tell you why she left so that you can get on with your life.
Well, I promise I'll do that. I promise. I also promise that that is a life that you're going to be heavily involved in.
What are you doing here?
Well, Mom, I thought that I would have a nightcap with Miss O'Hara's, okay?
Well, of course. It's fine. As you can see, I came up here with Craig and Emily. We were going to...
Look, I'm
going
to use the phone,
Dustin. No, you're not either, because if you do that, then Lily is going to come into Mona Lisa. Here, you're making plans for a birthday party, and we've got the supplies. You use the phone right over there.
Well, listen, I was just making stingers for Tom and myself. You wouldn't want one, would you?
I'll take one. No, you wouldn't dare take one.
Craig, I make the best.
Just a brandy, Shannon, thanks.
Brandy, that's good, brandy.
You want a brandy, too?
Well, buddy, sorry about interrupting. I hope that you and I are friends enough to not feel self-conscious or uncomfortable about this.
I'll tell you the truth, I don't feel either.
Oh, well, I'll tell you the truth. I happen to feel a little bit of both. I mean, I'm not used to seeing you with anybody but my sister.
Let me tell you something, Craig. Shannon and I have spent a good deal of time together these last few months, and she's pretty terrific. I mean, what any man would want. The kiss, I can explain the kiss. You see, that's as far as this relationship has gone, because Margot has emotionally crippled me so badly that I can't seem to pick up with anyone else.
No, I do understand what you're going through. I really do. I'm going through the same thing myself.
At the risk of being cruel, I know you're going through your own personal hell dealing with the loss of your wife, but no disrespect meant. I don't think you do understand. You see, what you're dealing with has some point of finality, a period, some kind of ending, and no one would blame you for picking up with someone else to live your life, but that is not the case with Margot. You see, everyone knows that she's still out there, and she never hesitates to pick up the phone and remind everyone of that, which she did tonight again at my house. Yeah, that's right. Our Margot, the one that wants me out of her life, the one that wants me to forget her, called to see how Leanne was. So I did the only thing I could think of, being tired. I came to Shannon to see if maybe she would help chase the ghost of Margot away, and she can't, and I can't seem to get rid of it.
Here's your brandy, Craig. Why don't you make that phone call now? Because it's getting kind of late. I sensed you needed cavalry.
Yeah, I did, boy. Thank you. It's always been Tom and Margot, Margot and Tom. You don't say one name without saying the other, and it's very hard to face the fact that maybe they've got something they just can't get over. It's very hard to let go of people's dreams.
Yes, it is.
So how's Betsy?
Well, she's incredible, you know. She's really an incredible woman. I don't know what's going on with her and Josh, but whatever it is, she's serious about it, and she's dealing with it in a very mature, very calm way, and she's not making any hasty decisions about anything. She's just amazing.
Yes, she is.
Yeah, she
is.
Really is. So where are Caleb and Holden?
Caleb went to the cellar.
He went to the cellar? God, that makes me mad. I told him specifically not to go down there. No, thank you.
Oh,
God, because Holden was going down there to talk to Lily.
Well, Holden is back up in his room and is packing to leave for Chicago.
Tonight?
Yes, tonight. And I told him not to make any rash decisions, and I just hope he's taking my advice. Hello?
Iva, hi, it's Craig. Listen, how was dinner with Hank? Any bulletins?
It was a very special evening, one I'll remember for a long time.
That sounds promising.
We agreed to be friends.
Oh. Nothing wrong with that.
So, what can I do for you?
Well, it's Holden there. I need to speak with him about Lily's birthday party. Also, see if I can find out what's bugging him, too.
I think you're one person that can do that. Let me go get him.
Craig? It's Emma. I have a bone to pick with you. How come you haven't been out to see me in a while?
And I feel the loss, believe me. Listen, I gotta go out of town for a few days, but when I get back, I'll stop by, all right?
Well, you better, and you bring Brian, too, you hear?
I will, but you won't recognize him. It's incredible how much he's changed.
I'm sure he has. He must be a great joy to you.
More than I can say. Although every time I look at him, I realize how much I miss his mother.
I don't know. His car's gone. Do you know where he went?
Oh, probably back to the cellar to eat a fight with Caliber to make up with Lily.
No, I don't think so, Meg, because Lily called earlier and she and Holden had a fight about Josh.
About Josh?
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I guess Holden and Josh had a run-in of some kind.
Do you know what it was about?
Oh, I don't know. I guess the usual thing, except this time Holden threatened Josh.
I saw Holden earlier here with a gun. And it's not here now. What if he's gone after Josh with it? Holden!
Meg!
Holden!
Meg, come back here!
I just don't think that we can get back to what we had. And I don't think it's fair of me to keep giving you false hope.
I don't think we have to decide this right
yes,
now.
Yes, I think we do.
I should have never told you about Meg.
Yeah, I felt hurt by that, Rod. I felt betrayed. But what frightens me more is what I said to you at the end of our argument.
You were upset.
What happened between you and Iva was nearly 20 years ago. You've been trying to make up for it ever since. I had no right to throw that
up to you.
See,
it was said in the heat of an argument.
Did you sleep with Meg those two times to hurt me?
No. No, I was very alone and upset. I guess I went to her for comfort. No, Betsy, I love you.
Well, I wanted to hurt you. I did, don't you see that? I tried to pretend that what we had was still there, but it's just not true for me anymore. And it made me angry and frustrated because I wanted to love you the same way that you love me, the way you deserve to be loved. And I just don't. I thought I was being loving and caring and thoughtful, but I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
No, I wasn't. I can't lie to you anymore. I can't lie to myself anymore. It's over.
You don't love me?
I'll always treasure what we had, you know that?
Betsy, I want you to go now, okay? Please?
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you today by Crisco Shortening. Bring them home to Crisco Home Cooking. And by Pringles potato chips, now in 9 delicious varieties. We'll continue with part 2 of As the World Turns in just a moment. And now part 2 of As the World Turns.
If you're here to pick up our fight where we left it off, I'm not in the mood, okay? Hey, this is my home. I don't want you here. You don't belong here. You're not welcome. Get the hell out of here.
I think I was crazy to come here, but I have something very important.
Yeah, I have heard everything you got to say to me.
Yeah,
okay?
Well, you haven't heard this.
Now, what is it? Let's hear it.
I don't understand it. But Lily really thinks of you as her father.
I am her father. I am her father.
I've been trying to imagine what I would feel like if Lily thought of Mom the way I thought about you. And it would be hard for me to know she thought that way about how I feel about you.
No, it's more than that, Holden. You said it yourself. You're sorry you didn't finish me off. Those are your words, Holden.
It was very difficult for me to come here tonight.
Really? What do you want?
Tomorrow is Lily's birthday party, and I want it to be special. I want her to see both of us in the same room. I'm willing to meet you halfway.
What?
Lily reminded me today of what a mess I made of her birthday party last year. And I was on the verge of heading to Chicago tonight and doing it again. I don't want that to happen. I'm running out of chances with Lily.
You know, my daughter really loves you. You know that?
And I really love your daughter. So will you meet me halfway?
I've always been willing to meet anybody in your family more than halfway, three-quarters way.
Yeah, well, it changes nothing between us. We're just doing it for Lily's sake. That's all I wanted to say to you.
No, 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 whoa, 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 you're wrong. Hold it. Just you to come here, show up and say what you said. A lot's changed. Hey, I'm always willing to make something right in my life if I possibly can.
Any for your thoughts?
I was just thinking how many different meanings the word love has for different people.
Thanks, everybody. Thanks, you've been a great audience. See you tomorrow night.
I always feel sorry seeing Pam alone while you're singing.
No, it's okay. I don't think she minds.
I don't mind, but I did like the company for a change.
Lily?
Yes, Andy.
What's up?
Pam tells me that Spence finally talked to Dusty in Rome.
Yes. Well, after the hassle we went through to find Dusty, it was kind of a letdown.
How so?
Well, they had been out of touch for such a long time. They weren't the close cowboy friends we thought they were.
Then how come Spence came all this way to look Dusty up?
Well, if he hadn't shown up in the same ranch as Dusty was 2 years ago, he probably never would have been there.
Well, if you were bumming around the world with no particular destination at all, wouldn't you just drift towards the one connection that you have, even though it was a faint one?
Then why drifting around, and why is he heading east if he doesn't have anything lined up there?
Lily, I would like you to meet my tall, blonde bulldog. He just kind of gets his teeth around the bone, you know, and then he just doesn't let go. Give the cowboy a break, will you?
Man, what did Dusty say about Spence?
Just that he didn't know him that well. Well, he did say that he thought something mysterious had happened to him, but he couldn't remember any of the details. He said he would let me know if it had come back to him.
Lily, you've just given him another bone.
10 minutes. I can give you an official birthday gift.
Oh, is it that late?
Yep. And I hope you'll be staying at your mother's tonight. That way I'll have two beautiful women all to myself.
Well, I get the impression that you and Hank had another important conversation tonight.
Yes, we did. He made it very clear that he has a serious relationship in New York, and he doesn't want to change that.
Where does that leave you?
With a very good friend.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was hoping this was going to go somewhere with him. I like Hank. I think he fits right in here with his family.
Why don't you tell him that sometime?
Well, not exactly a point now, is there?
Well, I think he'd like to hear it from you. How's Betsy?
Oh, I'm a little worried about her. She's dealing with a lot these days. I'm just trying to be supportive and not push her, you know? Look, I got so much energy. I'm gonna go upstairs and try and knock off a couple of perfect paragraphs. Hit the sack, okay?
All right.
I hope when Caleb and Holden get back that maybe they won't tear the place apart.
Good night.
Good night.
I thought you went to bed.
No.
You didn't say anything to Mom or Seth about Holden maybe leaving here with a gun, did you?
No, Meg. I didn't say anything. I didn't want to worry them needlessly. Now, I'm going to bed. Are you coming?
Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna, call Tony. I can't sleep unless I can speak to him. He's still early in California.
All right. Good night.
Goodness, you're there. Are you all right?
Yeah, I guess so. Why?
I heard about your fight with Holden. I was worried he might have come after you.
As a matter of fact, he did. And something very interesting happened.
Something very interesting happened? What?
Oh, as my baby. You look so tired.
I am. Aww. Give you 20 minutes to cut out that back row. I'm going to head on home and hit the sack.
You do that. Oh, Shannon, I'm going downstairs. I'll be back in a little bit. I'm going to help Jimmy close up. Oh, Tom, I don't think I will ever feel the same about Margo. Not after all this. I mean, what she's done to you and to Lila, Casey, and Craig, and everybody.
You know, Mom, that's all just part of the mystery. It's so unlike her. Maybe I just didn't know her as well as I thought. Mm.
Good night.
And you?
Yes.
Thank you for the stinger and the sympathetic ear, or both ears if they were both listening.
Sure. You know, you got me thinking. Maybe I didn't know Duncan as well as I thought I did either, even though I lived with him all those months, so... While you are out and about sleuthing around about Margo, I'm going to find out what's behind that mask of the man I thought I knew.
You know, that worries me because I don't want to see you in any danger.
Don't worry, read my lips. I can take care of myself.
I know. Actually, I'm getting used to having you around, and I don't want to lose you. And Duncan always seems to be in danger.
You don't have to be worried about losing me, Tommy. No matter what we find in our searches, you and I can't lose what we've already found.
So, who won?
You did.
You're gonna have no problem getting to school at all. Maybe it's Scrabble.
Andy, do you know how important it is for me to go to an American public high school? In Vietnam, my mother had to teach me in secret because if we were ever caught, we would have been in so much trouble.
Just Oakdale High, it's no big deal.
Well, it will make me feel like I belong.
But you do belong. Of course you belong here.
I know, but it'll make me feel less separate, you know?
Oh, I don't know what you mean.
That's because you know me, and you do not see what others do.
Such as?
Such as, even though my name is Hughes now, the color of my skin will always be different, the shape of my eyes, where I came from.
Don't you think I see those differences? I see them. Those are the differences that make you so special.
Well, thank you, but that's not what I meant. I just want for a few minutes to be ordinary, you know?
Oh, Leanne, you'll never be ordinary. And you shouldn't want to be.
Well, it's late, and I should get to bed, and I should let you get some sleep.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Thank you for saying goodnight.
Okay. It was fun.
It was fun.
Oh, I hope that's going to be comfortable.
Oh. Fine. Sleep like a baby.
Good night.
Good night. I know she likes me. got your back safe.
I will always remember you running into the barn where Dune was holding me prisoner.
I'll always remember holding you in my arms. I've wanted to do that for so long.
I think I should go.
It's Paul, isn't it?
He's not just your cousin. He's your best friend, and what I feel for you is wrong.
No. It's not wrong. Denying our feelings for each other because of someone else is wrong. I see you and Paul together. And I try and forget my feelings for you, but I just can't do that anymore.
Many, many, many happy returns.
Oh, thanks for remembering.
Remembering? Come on, are you kidding? Your birthday should be a national holiday. We should call it Lily Day. I suppose your mother hasn't beaten me to the punch in California.
I just think she's a little confused with the time zones and everything. She did send Ambrose out to the farm with my birthday present, though. Stock certificates.
Stock certificates? Richer and richer.
Can we move this line along a little, please? Hmm?
Thank you.
See you later.
Bye.
Happy birthday, Lily.
Thanks.
I hope you'll spend the first part of it out at the pond with me.
Hmm? Oh, why don't you get some breakfast for the pizza?
I agree. Excuse me. Happy birthday. I hope it's the best ever.
Oh. Happy birthday. Oh, thank you.
Really? Well, then it is finally officially your birthday. Many happy returns of the day, and I am going to let you go now, and you go out and celebrate,
oh,
all right? Sally? Oh, yes, birthday girl is right here. For you, some handsome young man, I'm sure.
Oh, hello.
Hello, Lily. I wanted to be one of the first people to wish you happy birthday to you.
Thank you. I'm really glad you called.
There's something else I want to tell you, too. Holden stopped by a little while ago and made an attempt to have things get better. Lily, did you hear me?
Yes.
He did it for you, you know.
I can't believe it.
Believe it. I'll tell you all about it tomorrow, okay?
That's wonderful news. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Have a great day.
I will. Really
will.
Bye.
Where to now?
That's just been decided. I'm gonna go out to the farm and thank Holden Snyder for the best birthday present he's ever given me.
Thinking about Margot again?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Well, I know that it really threw you to see Tom with Shannon.
Yeah, it did come as a bit of a surprise. I mean, I know that they've been seeing each other. It's just something I'll have to get used to, I guess.
I understand the feeling.
Yeah?
Even after I knew that everything was over between Holden and me, I couldn't deal with the fact that he'd be back with Lily. I don't know why, but I'm okay now, though.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I want to get this divorce over with so he can pursue his feelings for her. I don't know if you know this about your partner, but he's a real Puritan where morals are concerned. And he won't. He won't make any moves on Lily until he's a free man.
It's probably the same for Tom. But emotional ties are pretty tricky things, you know. And just because you got a little legal piece of paper doesn't mean you're free. And on the other hand, if Holden and Tom feel that they're free without the legal paper, I can't judge them. I know what longings are, needs, what it's like to be lonely.
Me too.
Which just further proves how unfair and how unjust this world can be.
Thank you.
And it makes me wonder if I'm free. If I have the right.
I just don't think we can get back to what we had. And I don't think it's fair of me to give you any false hope.
I'm going to start tomorrow knowing that it's over with Betsy.
This portion of As the World Turns has been brought to you by Milk-Bone Dog Biscuits, the dog biscuit that gets dog's teeth naturally cleaner, whiter, and breath fresher. Stay tuned for Guiding Light next on most of these CBS stations. Children's Clothes by Good Lad of Philadelphia. Join us tomorrow for As the World Turns.